Hello. Yes, what is Nick Griffin up to? I make this video because people have been asking me, what do you think Nick Griffin's up to, given the nonsense he's been pushing the last few years? Back to the land. He was pushing that in the 1980s when he was leader of the National Front in that silly magazine, Nationalism Today. If you can get a copy on eBay, read it. Christ, God help us. But anyway, he's pushing this nonsense back to the land. Separate from Sodom. He refers to the system as Sodom. It's a probably good description. That we should separate from the system now and all become independent. Fruit and veg growers, food producers. I'm assuming you've got your own commune you're all going to descend upon, which you've yet to name. Is anyone moving to this commune? Or do you just do it individually, independently, like say, where I am here in Norrisgreen, Liverpool, I just go independent. I switch all the gas and lecky off and start growing fruit and veg in the back garden. I leave my car and get a horse-drawn cart. I mean, it's ridiculous. You can't separate from the system. How do you communicate with people then, Nick Griffin, if you separate from Sodom, the system? If there's no internet, there's no mobile phones, there's no landlines, there's no cars, there's no oil, petrol, whatever. How do you communicate? Or don't you? Or aren't you supposed to? You can't separate from the system. It is ludicrous and you know it. And that's why people have been phoning me, messaging me and asking me, what do you think Nick Griffin's up to? Do you think he's rolled to the enemy? Well, I don't think he's rolled to the enemy at all. I just think it's a serious, embarrassing cop-out to continue in the job he started because he's made such a mess of it, except make plenty of money in the European Parliament, his pension fund. Maybe that's all the only reason he joined the BNP for back in the 90s was to get elected to the European Parliament, get his pennies and pounds, status, ego, and he was off. Maybe that's been the case. I don't know, but it looks like. I mean, if you really believe it's all over, and we've got to build these white communities around the country, whatever they are, unnamed as usual, then fair enough. But by telling up-and-coming young, you know, enthusiastic nationalists that it's all over, forget it now, it's futile, is wrong. If you want to go and do that, great. But why are you doing it when you know it's a load of baloney? Like I've said, separate from Sodom means separating. And that means everything, doesn't it? You can't use Sodom's roads, Sodom's petrol, electricity, gas, mobile phones, landlines. You can't use anything if you're separating from the system. It is ludicrous, literally ludicrous. And the only people I can separate are those that have got money. And even then, you'd have to just stay on the land you've acquired unless you had a horse-drawn cart. I mean, the whole lot of it is just that stupid. I tell you what, I'll have a debate with you if you want. We'll hook up on some webcam and we can have a debate on it. You should wipe the floor with me. You were a political heavyweight at one time. I'm an old one. But you couldn't even hold your own against me. I believe what's happened is you've handed the BNP over, not deliberately, well, I'd like to think so, but not deliberately, over to the enemy. They made a fool of you. You were getting warned over at least a period of 5 years what was happening. The enemy was moving in and taking the BNP from you. You were told not to hand the membership over to Hope Not Hate Spies, Sadie Graham and Matt Zingle. Yeah, you did. You passed thousands and thousands of people's private details over to the enemy. Will they ever trust British nationalism again? I don't know. So that's what I believe has happened. Others are a bit more suspicious, but I believe that's what's happened. I think you've joined the BNP just to get elected to the European Parliament. Pennies and pounds, pension fund, ego status, all that like. And then what you are ever going to do with the BNP, I don't know. But the enemy, maybe conveniently, I don't know, took it from you. Now, instead of getting back in there and continuing this fight, because there's plenty of fight left in us, but we've got millions and millions of people here. We outnumber the third world here at the moment. So we can do this still. And we want real community power. We don't go and build these fantasy communes and all live off the land. We go into Burnley and Oldham and Blackburn and all these other white communities already established with thousands of our voters living there. We go back into them places and start winning elections, and we have economic, political and social power in those areas. That's what we do. instead of this fantasy nonsense that you're coming out with. And it is a fantasy, Nick. I drove round with you for over 3 years, and I know you as best as you probably do, and you know all that's a load of nonsense. They are terrified. The powers that be and our enemies, hope not hate, Nick Lowles, Jenny Gable, Circle Magazine, and the big boys, MI5, they fear electoral power. They are terrified, right? And at the present moment, the way the country is, British nationalism would be skyrocketing. It'd be unstoppable, right? But there is no British nationalism, because not only did you hand it over to the enemy, you're stopping it flourishing by pushing this stupid nonsense back to the land. Let's grow our tomatoes on the windowsill or on the back garden or whatever. Separate from Sodom. Let's all go round in horse-drawn carts and whatever. You know, it's just ludicrous, Nick. You know it is, right? And like I've said, where's this place is it all going to relocate to? Where's this commune you're all building? Or aren't you? Or is this just an individual thing people do? Well, I live here in Norwich Green, Liverpool. What do I do then? Switch all the gas and electricity off and go and grow tomatoes in the back garden. It's that stupid, isn't it? So therefore, you must have a place where we're all going to suppose to relocate to. Yeah, well, where? Well, nowhere. It's just a fantasy nonsense that the enemy's probably laughing, you know, its head off over. It must be just thinking what's happened to this once powerful political heavyweight now pushing this ludicrous hogwash, because that's what it is. You know it is, right? What the enemies of Britain fear, and the enemies of British nationalism fear, is a up and running British Nationalist Party winning elections. They are terrified of that, right? Literally. And we can easily do all that again, but we've got people like you. Now, why are you doing it? That's my opinion. I think you've joined the BNP, used it as a career move. You're that now embarrassed to put right what you've made wrong by starting a British Nationalist Party and getting it back up and running at least, and then handing it over to someone else if you just want to retire on your plot of land, growing your tomatoes. Fair enough. But you've got no right, given what you've made out of British nationalism and what other people sacrificed like myself. You can't just walk away from this. Obviously you can, and you are doing, but it's shameful, isn't it? You want to hang your head in shame, Nick Griffin, for what you've done, and especially patronising the British white nationalist community the world over with this hogwash about back to the land, separating from Sodom. There is no parliamentary road. So let's all form these communes and do what? Okay, we separate from Sodom and do what? Okay, thank you.
Our activity must be geared to the winning of power. That still has to be said to some people in our movement, here in America, back in Britain, and everywhere else. They are crusaders for the truth, but they don't relate it to the necessities of winning power. It cannot be said enough. Power is what must be won. First, just a little bit of power, then more power, and finally complete power. Activity geared to anything else is a waste of time.